Okay, I got 7 o'clock. This is our, you know, regular town board meeting of June 29th, when we meet on Tuesday nights, Wednesday. Of the elected, prior election yesterday. We do have a public hearing. Now ask the town clerk to read all your votes.
Please take notice that a public hearing will be held by the town board of town of Farmington on the 29th day of June 2022 at 7 PM at the Farmington Town Hall, 1000 Conover Lee, Farmington, New York, regarding the adoption of a local law which would authorize a town board and other public bodies of the town to use video conference technology to participate in public meetings as permitted by section 103-A of open meetings law. Any resident of the town of Farmington shall be entitled to be heard upon said proposed local law at such public hearing. Copies of said proposed local law are available for review at the town of Farmington Town Hall, 1000 Conover Lee. This is a resolution of the town board of the town of Farmington.
Thank you. So, this resolution is a requirement. We want to continue doing video conferencing for town board meetings. It's also applicable for zoning board appeals or planning board. It's optional for our other committees and the advisory boards that we have. It's because the emergency in New York State was extended, but only for a limited amount of time. And the New York State law that they passed was you have to put something formal in place. So our town attorney drafted up this local law for us. If anybody had any questions, that there is a restriction that majority of the board has to be here, or for the other boards, the majority of the board has to be present in order to conduct business. Have a pretty good reason not to be in person and in a video conference at all. Next questions from the audience. Anybody online? Any questions? Hearing none, I close the public hearing. Carol, I'm going to ask you to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Next thing on the agenda is approval of our town board's minutes from June 14th.
Second.
Motion second. Any comments, corrections? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Privilege of the floor or public concerns? Any privilege of the floor or public concerns from the audience today? Anybody online? Privilege of the floor or public concerns? Hearing none, we'll go right straight to Public Works, one of the standing committees.
Yeah, we met yesterday morning, actually at the wastewater treatment plant. Down at the treatment plant, we talked a lot about digester one of the last few meetings. The cleaning, all that has been wrapped up. They're still working on a wall repair that has begun, and working on pricing for a heat exchanger pump. Hope to have that back online within about the next 2 months. They have began working on a secondary clarifier, just emptying tank for doing some maintenance and repair. Got notified we need some cooling fan to be replaced on one of the low lift pumps down there. And they're also flushing bio tower one, just doing quarterly maintenance on that. Just general, water main replacement at 332 and 96. The new tentative start date of that is the week of July 11th. Again, that will be a lengthy project at that intersection. Talked a lot about the fence installation, everything. We're just waiting on the final kind of hookups to occur there. But all the hardware and everything has been installed. Farmington Canandaigua Town Line Road, just waiting on the rest of the 12-inch pipe to be delivered to finish that. That's set to be delivered around July 11th as well. Flow testing on our sewer mains, that's ongoing. Our operator is working with MRB on the next locations for those installs. And we have a resolution tonight. They have also been working over on Wagon Road on a pump station project there. Manhole top is in. And like I said, we have a resolution just for a bunch of the parts. And also got a quote for some fabrication from a vendor that needs to be done over there as well. Highway and parks, kind of a lot of the same ongoing equipment maintenance. They were out on 332 doing the second round of state mowing out of the July 4th holiday. They're working on shoulders on town line, Loomis Road as well. Taking out some dead ash trees on Yon and Yellow Mills Road, and just some general tree trimming and around the roadways and also around signs. Parks, again, ongoing maintenance, mowing is, that's going to be on the report for the next few months for sure. And then recreation started this week, so they've been doing prep work for rec. And he's got one resolution on tonight, just for a new hire in the Parks Department. So let's speak up.
Thank you. And town operations.
And town operations met yesterday. Two resolutions we've been talking about have come up. We'll start off with some good news and good things come to those to wait. And the TAP grant was finally sent out by the state, and we have been awarded a little over $1.7 million for our sidewalk project. So hopefully the construction costs are going up. That's going to cover a big chunk of the sidewalk project and trail connections, pedestrian bridge. Like Rob Burrell is working on an MRB and working on that grant bus. So letters were sent out to some property owners that back up to the Auburn Trail and the Beaver Creek Park. Just some issues that we're having with some structures that are crossing over in the parkland, debris and garage that have dumped on town land, and homeowners are working to clear up those issues. On the 14th of July, we're meeting with the town, we're meeting with the DOT and the three major landowners to discuss the signalized intersection there for the Little Quarry project, and we're also connected to the TOPS plaza, work that out. And we'll also be, Tom Ward's going to have a presentation at the July 12th meeting, looking for rezoning of a parcel at 332 in Loomis, like they want to put in some warehouse space there. We have a couple of vacancies on the Conservation Board, three, and then, unfortunately, Jerry Marshall, the chairman of the Zoning Board of Appeals, he is moving, so he has had to resign his position there. So we have an opening on the ZBA as well.
Thank you. Reports from other town officials, supervisor, like for people that haven't met Dave Conte yet, welcome to today's meeting. He'll be our new water and sewer superintendent. Probably starting the week of July 18th. We're already loaded in with financials and other DEC information, and he's met with some of the water and sewer staff already. So, Dave, thanks for attending today. Everybody wants to know, so I am scheduled for surgery next Thursday. Don't have a time yet on my foot. Get a cast on 2 weeks and then move for whatever during physical therapy. And just to remind the department heads, the budget sheets for 2023 will go up for the departments probably next week. That's all I have. Highway and parks.
Oh, not much to add to what Steve already said, other than the stripers are in town, you may notice, on a few of the roads. Some of the first round got that some of them are done. I think maybe they got most of them done. I did get a call back from Doyle today about the phone lines here. They'll be in tomorrow afternoon to apparently they need to make the connection for the Sunday or part of it.
Right.
So they'll be in tomorrow. We were working on the shoulders on Loomis Road until that road widener broke down. So I've been out there trying to help them sort that and figure that out. So then we got a part on order. I don't know when it's going to be here. But.
That's a shared cost with Victor.
Yes. So other than that, the other thing is, I want to let everybody know that I'll be out of town next week on vacation. So any calls or anything urgent comes up, you know, give Warren a call or Jeff will be back from vacation. So be a good one. I'll be in the other round next.
Nice.
I don't know if I'll have service up there or not. So it's today or best.
Just so you won't.
I won't.
All right. And then you have some work probably to begin in the next week. Okay. On the Sullivan.
Well, actually, next week we're helping Victor on the stone first. And then we'll come to our town. They probably won't be done with theirs until Thursday. So we'll be starting oil and stone Monday and then fiber mat right after that.
Yep. Week of the 11th.
Week of the 11th is where we're really scheduled. Possibly could oil and stone on in Green Road on Thursday if they get done early. Get everything built through, but
yeah.
I doubt it.
Yeah.
Probably been Monday.
Okay.
Very good. Town clerk.
So my office is still continuing working on the leave of dog licenses. We've got over 100 that we need to remove, but finally got them into renew. So we're working great on that. I'm going to officiate another marriage on Saturday morning here to Town Hall at 11 o'clock. And last week, the Clerk Association met at the Town Forum for a meeting and luncheon with Finger Lakes Visitors Connections.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. Water and Sewer, Robin is not here. I will say Dave spent probably an hour on the phone with me today, informing me that he's had a good meeting with Dave. He's equated in the operations. He met with Josh. He met with Mike Abraham and the two ladies that work over there. So Dave's off to a good start. And we're definitely going to hook you up with MRV and talk about that after the meeting. But we don't want to hold you up. I know you got to drive back tonight. Buildings only.
Well, I'm going to start off with continuing with that good news about grants. We were awarded the scanning grant again this year. It's a continuation. We applied for it last year. We started the building department, got probably 85 to 90% of all of our files done. The next grant is that we got approved for was to finish the files in the building department and then to start on the files in water and sewer. It also included software so that water and sewer had somewhere to store all these files after they're scanned. So I'll be working with Dave here when he kind of gets settled in a little bit, and we'll talk about the different software programs that we have reviewed and what we thought was the best at the time that we applied for the grant. Doesn't mean that it's what we have to go with, but at least it gives us a good direction. So that's some great news to go along with the TAP grant that we got. So. Also, we've been busy on code updates with Ron, and we had some issues over at the Chinese restaurant, but we're happy to inform everybody that that's back open as of today. So they will have to be closed again for a little bit when they upgrade some more equipment, but they're going in the right direction, so they are open for now.
And the current permit's happy.
So far. we're hoping that we'll continue to be happy there. Dollar General, if you've gone by there, that has been pretty much fully removed. They'll finish that tomorrow and hopefully be out of here before the holiday weekend. That will be just down to the slab. So that's the plan there. And then the last big thing is we got a big event here this weekend with fireworks. So I've been working with all the different departments, and I think we're in good shape.
Yep, we've asked for sheriff road deputies coverage, ambulance car to be here, the fire car to be here, and a couple, 2,000 to 3,000 people. And it's an extended extended firework show thanks to the donation of Farmington Chamber, gave us an extra $1,500 towards fireworks. So looking forward to everybody enjoying it. Plan board.
Certainly, we got coming up next Thursday, July 6th, or Wednesday, July 6th, we have the final subdivision reapproval for the Loomis Road Industrial Park. We have the final two-lot subdivision for Bowerman. We have the preliminary site plan approval for Bowerman. We have the final site plan reapproval for Union Crossing Blackwood. And then we have the final site plan approval for Safe Place. And then a discussion about the Town of Victor Stonebrook subdivision project. So pretty much wraps it up. Could be relatively easy meeting, not a whole lot of discussion, other than our disapprovals on the Bowerman project. Yeah, I got a lot of comments. Other than that, we're good to go.
Thanks, Ed.
Yeah,
Ron, planning and development.
All right, just we'll follow up on the CAP grant. I think the success for that CAP grant, in part, is attributed to the hard work that Lance did from MRB and preparing the sidewalk trail master plan map, which identified where the sidewalks are in town, where the voids are, and where we're proposing to construct sidewalks, trails, and a pedestrian bridge crossing of Beaver Creek. So thank you, MRB, for Lance's hard work on that. Also, Sarah Mitchell, I don't know what we've done without her working through the CAP grant forms and the computer that we had there. It was very helpful to have somebody who had the skills to do that. We will be meeting with representatives from the Cobblestone Performing Arts Center. They're moving forward with the plans for expansion over there. I also talked today with Jonathan Orkin, Pioneerman Millworks, New Energy Works. He's going to be coming in with, I believe, something interesting in the near future here. We met this morning with town staff to go over the redesign of the stormwater pond for Auburn Meadows AS, and be sending out a letter to that effect tomorrow. And other than that, the list of CAP grants that were awarded in the Finger Lakes region totaled some $23 million, almost $24 million. Dollars. And while you know the 1.7 million sounds like a lot of money, keep in mind, as Nate said, it was based on cost estimates from last year.
Actually, like late 2020, probably, right?
No, it was.
Was it 21?
Okay. And the other thing to keep in mind is that looks as though 2023 is going to be a very slow year, so there might be some under contractors out there looking for work to do. We'll see what happens with these interest rates and everything else. Other than that, Dan, and my report on common ops has been filed and posted and distributed. It's on the website. And that's all I have for now.
All right, Ron, thanks. County engineer, Bill.
Yeah, just a couple quick things. We did hold a pre-con yesterday for the relining of the water main under the 2A. So that'll get moving forward. All right, a couple things that we touched on. But we are waiting on Department of Health and DOT on the Route 332 water main, separate project from the 96 intersection. And we have a meeting tomorrow, so I'm going to talk about the sewer master plan. So we'll be defining the next location of those meters tomorrow. There's a resolution on tonight, but manhole rehab will be awarded. So we'll be moving ahead with that project as well. So some more recap for DEC.
Yep. Very good. Same for DEC. Careful, Ron.
Okay, thanks. No, Sessor's not here. Candidate this week. And recreation are off to a great start first week. And we did have some numbers that Ron put in the his report of attendance by the parks. So everything is going good so far. Communications are on file. Reports and minutes are on file. First resolution is authorized the adoption by the town board of the town of Farmington, local law number 5 of 2022. In fact, a local law authorizes the town board and other public bodies of the town to use video conferencing technology to participate in public meetings. So,
second.
Motion to second. Any additional comments? Correction?
I want to thank Dan for taking over as AV director as well. And I think the board is a very large raise to give. I'm to put in the work to get some of this upgraded for the technical side of it, obviously the video conferencing for the meetings is probably going to be more and more vital in the future, so good to get that out.
Yes. All right, thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Two's resolution operating the Highland Park Superintendent to fill labor position in the Parks Department at a rate of $17.50 an hour, and it's effective July 5th.
So moved.
Second. Motion second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Three's resolution establishing a penalty date for all unpaid 2022 second quarter accounts located within the County of Vermont Water District and the Victor Sewer Districts for Monday, August 1st, 2022.
So moved.
Second. Motion second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Four is a resolution authorizing town contributions to the HSAs.
So moved.
Second. I'll second.
So we have 10 people in the Simply Bronze HSA health plan. So they get a contribution in July and then they get one in December. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Five is a resolution accepting the final 2021 auto repairs from Raymond F. Wagner, Division of LMB and Company for the Town Clerk and Receiver of Taxes. Can we block 5 and 6? Any objections?
No.
This number 6 is also the audit for the justice accounts.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. Block 5 and 6. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. 7 is a resolution authorizing an agreement between the town of Farmington and the Farmington Fire Association for the use of the town fueling station.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. We have gone back and forth with the fire department and our legal counsel for a year now. And we finally got the words that our attorney and the fire department's attorney likes. And basically, they'll be off the run. They'll be able to use our fuel station for gasoline and diesel. Once we have the list of drivers and we already had it. Okay, good. I knew it was coming. List of drivers and the vehicles. And so we got to plug that into the fuel system. I can't remember. I think you said the week ago. What? We'll have it up and running by then.
Hey, Pete, I got the other two forms that Jimmy asked me to get, the liability and the workman's comp.
Okay.
All the forms are together in the. And if she needs the, if she needs the list of drivers and trucks, internet or
digital,
we can do that. So I got a hard copy.
Yeah.
But we can easily do that.
Okay.
And then the addition is that we can work that well.
All right.
As long as we don't get a mileage on that. Yeah.
That's the stuff
I gave to Jimmy. Yeah. Great. That will move us along. Great. Thank you. I'll have a first and a second, didn't you?
Yeah.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Resolution number 8, awarding advanced rehabilitation technology, and that's for our 2022 manhole rehabilitation project.
So moved.
Second.
This is the same company we used the last
couple of years. They are on the Ontario County bid this, and this year includes an 8.5% increase in bill. I forget how many animals we want.
55 comes to mind?
No, it's not that many.
We talked about it yesterday morning.
Yeah,
I couldn't find stuff in my head. Mm-hmm.
We'll make sure we'll just attach a copy of this. Again, it's the same company used. We got a motion and a second, right?
Yep.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right. Nine, resolution authorizing a budget amendment, transferring money from the appropriated fund balance of water. New engineering water for around 40,000.
So moved.
Second. Motion of the second. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Aye. Has a resolution supporting the submission of a local government efficiency grant application to the New York Department of State and authorizing a memorandum of understanding to facilitate the Ontario County Electric's Electronic Contract and Insurance Lifecycle Management Solution Implementation Project.
Couple.
Second. Personal
second.
It is an awful.
Yeah.
So this is Ontario County has electronics contract system for their vendors or their towns, like we get paid for mowing and plowing and sanding. And so now they're opening up to the towns, the villages, and the cities for the same system. And so this would be a study towards a grant award. So we'll just see where it goes. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. What is the resolution authorizing acceptance of an easement and stormwater control facility maintenance agreement affecting the RG project?
Second.
There's two parts. This is the easement for them, and then there's the right of entry form for us to go in on the property when we have to. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 12 is the resolution authorizing appointment of Daniel Hassan for the position of clerk to the town of justice effective 5 July at a rate of 17.50 an hour.
So moved.
Second.
Motion is second. Vacancy's been there for a while with the resignation of Merle. And Dan was one of the clerks doing it part time. There were two clerks doing it part time to fill in the time here. So we welcome him joining us. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 13 is a resolution authorizing the purchase of sewer fittings and supplies for the emergency repair of PS. That says 24, isn't it 25?
Yeah.
The man, yeah.
Oh, man.
It's 25. So we'll change that. And it's total amount not to exceed $14,052.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Working resolution authorizing union lettering graphics to prepare for Drummond information signs in accordance with union's work order number 91299 dated June 8th, which are to be installed by the town parks or highway employees identified in the location of the Hickory Nature Trail that costs not to exceed $512.
So, second.
Motion second. Comments, questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Resolution 15, declaring miscellaneous equipment for the town hall or surplus and will be disposed of or add an auction or discard.
Second.
Well, we got a battery backup for a computer system and a old computer that's been recycled out. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 16, the resolution authorizing the town supervisor to take appropriate action to sign lawn mowing contracts and to apply lawn mowing charges to the property within the town of Farmington to the tax.
So moved.
Second.
Motion second, and this for 32 proposed light. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 17 in the abstract to pay bills. Number abstract number 12. General fund $74,323.33. Highway fund $68,568.97. Beaver Creek Park $103.10. Fuel station capital project $607.35. Water tank repair $828. Town line capital project $1,299.40. Storm drainage $2,298.18. Lighting district $1,340.59. Sewer district $59,824.23. Water district, never seen it this low before, $14,058.40. Payroll deduction $7,070.53. For a total abstract $230,322.08. And motion please.
So moved. Second.
Motion second. Any extensions? Corrections? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. And no training under $100. No items for discussion. Any final comment from the public? No executive session in and no waivers of the rules.
We agreed to that third meeting?
Pardon?
Didn't mean to be there July 3rd. July 3rd, everybody here, and what kinds of bands start?
The favorite, the food is at 5 on the bands at 6 or 7. So,
yeah, that'd be like
5:30ish.
Yeah, it was not doing fire. It was quite a big turnout. Hopefully the vendors bring more food because something sold out last year.
I saw something where they might be doing it on the 4th.
The 3rd.
Doing the same night.
The yard?
The business
is big money. Yeah,
Canada
was not doing it. It's all business
groups. Right? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, okay. So doing it in
Canada. Yeah. I saw the town wasn't. But it's banded together. So
all right. They might they cut down on their tractor. Excellent. Anything else from staff?
Motion to adjourn.
Of we did.
No, okay. We didn't. We passed it right
in. Same one. Just did.
So
all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
And you got to teach them how to do
that. That's what I appreciate.